Squeaks, our friends took so many photos from their vacations last year.
Hey, you want to play a game?
I'll show you a photo, and you tell me what you can see in it. Okay, here's the first one. Are you sure it's just a plant? I think you should look again. That's right! There's a caterpillar hiding in plain sight. Actually, I think this is a hornworm. Hornworms are caterpillars that use their green color and smooth body shapes to blend into the plants they like to eat, including tomato plants. So sneaky. Okay. How about this one? Oh, you think it's bird poop? Nope. It's another caterpillar. This species or type of caterpillar spends a lot of its time on the tops of leaves, which I do admit can have bird poop on them too. Okay, last one. You're catching on, Squeaks. This may look just like a stick, but it's actually a caterpillar too. And unless you sat and watched them for a really long time, you wouldn't realize that they're not part of the plant they're munching on. But most predators don't have the time to do that. I guess I was playing a little trick on you. I showed you photos of caterpillars that looked like something else. They were camouflaged. Camouflage is a way to hide in plain sight by blending into your surroundings. You or I can put on clothes to camouflage ourselves, like wearing a shirt covered in a green leaf pattern to hide in a forest. But many animals have camouflage built into their bodies, including many caterpillars. Can you think of why a caterpillar might want to camouflage themselves? Good idea, Squeaks! Caterpillars are basically a protein-packed gummy worm. They crawl around the garden eating all day long, building up the energy and supplies they'll need inside their body to transform into a butterfly or a moth. But those little caterpillars can't move very quickly, and what predator wouldn't want to snack on a slow, savory gummy worm? So in order to make it to that butterfly phase of their lives, caterpillars have to come up with creative tricks to avoid being eaten, so they can grow up into beautiful butterflies and make some more caterpillars. And one of the tricks is camouflage. A predator probably wouldn't have the patience to sit and stare at a plant to see if one of its sticks is really a piece of food. And just like you thought the caterpillar that looked like bird poop was gross, so would the animals that want to eat a delicious caterpillar. Oh, camouflage isn't a trick the caterpillars were taught. The instructions for how to look like bird poop or a stick are inside a caterpillar's body. Scientists call that special look a trait, and the caterpillar inherited or was passed down the instructions for that trait from their parents, who also looked like bird poop or a stick. Can you think of a trait that I inherited from my parents? That's right, I do have the same nose as my dad. But the instructions to make human facial features are actually kind of complicated. So not every kid out there will have the same face as their parents. Also, having my dad's nose doesn't help me avoid getting eaten by predators. At least I'm pretty sure it doesn't. Great question. I did say camouflage was just one trick a caterpillar might use. So some caterpillars inherit different looks to keep themselves safe. For example, some are disguised to look like something that's way more dangerous than they really are. Check this one out. This is a hawk moth caterpillar. What do you notice about their markings and the shape or structure of their body? What do they remind you of? Yes, their body looks like the head of a venomous snake, which most predators know they should steer clear of. Yeah, the caterpillar inherited the traits to look like a snake, and their predators inherited the knowledge that snakes are dangerous. This is a hickory-horned devil caterpillar, which gets their name from the spikes all over their body. They sure look like they would be painful to eat, right? But they're actually really just a giant squishy thing. Those spikes are a trick but most predators wouldn't risk touching them anyway. Here's a caterpillar of a swallowtail butterfly. They have a brightly colored forked body part on their head that they flash when they feel threatened. But it's not just for show. This body part also releases a bad smell, which predators might think is poison. And here's a saddleback caterpillar, which combines a bunch of different tricks to survive. They're colorful and have a few large spiky-looking bits. But do you see those tiny hairs? The hairs have even tinier hooks that can dig into your skin. And once they're in, they can deliver a toxin. Yeah, that one is definitely a caterpillar you don't want to touch, as they can really hurt you. And there are other caterpillars who take that toxic hair trick to a whole new level. This one is sometimes called the toxic toupee because it looks like someone's wig crawling around. I guess they do look kinda cute, but you definitely don't want to touch them. The hairs cause stings that are incredibly painful, probably one of the worst stings you've ever felt. So the next time you see a caterpillar, see if you can spot what tricks and traits they may be using to avoid being eaten. Are they trying to hide? Are they trying to tell predators they'll taste yucky? And if you were a caterpillar, what traits would you want to have to help you survive until you become a beautiful butterfly? Thanks for thinking about these things with Squeaks and me today, and we'll see you next time here at the fort.